So we'll anyway start the competition, and we'll have each team come up and make their presentations, 5-minute presentation, and you know the points that we will be grading you on. Yeah, and there's just one little change. We will be giving the award of excellence to just one team, the best team. So may the best team win, and we'll start the competition.
Good afternoon, everybody. Myself, Mahesh, representing our team. Our team members are Mr. Sunil Kulkarni, Mr. Bhaskar, and Mr. Maurya. Jo particular aapse main plan discuss kar raha hun, it's regarding about wedding, organizing the unorganized wedding market. Theek hai, wedding market, as we all know, pure saal, puri jindagi hum bachate hain, to do cheezon pe kharch karte hain, ek wedding pe aur ek ghar pe. ठीक है, तो वेडिंग हमारी कम से कम 5 या 10 साल की जो सेविंग्स होती है, जो नॉर्मल जो पिरामिड हमने डिस्कस किया था, वो वेडिंग के ऊपर खर्च होता है, और अभी वो नॉर्मली जो इंडिया के अंदर अनऑर्गेनाइज्ड है हर तरीके से. ठीक है, तो इस साइट हम आईटी का यूज करके जो वेडिंग जो इंडस्ट्री है इसको ऑर्गेनाइज करने की कोशिश इसमें की गई है. इसमें बेसिकली क्या है, वेबसाइट है, उसके अंदर वेंडर्स, ये काफी जो और भी जगह आपने देखा होगा वेंडर्स जो अवेलेबल होंगे वेंडर्स के ऊपर, लेकिन इसमें डिफरेंस क्या होगा, वेंडर्स की रेटिंग, इसमें नीड जो है कस्टमर, एंड कस्टमर जिसके घर में वेडिंग है, उसका फादर है या जो वेंडर, उसको चाहिए वेंडर जो रिलायबल हो और उसके घर के पास हो, और नीड है वो इजिली मिल जाए, और उसकी एक नीड है कि उससे शादी जैसा जो मेजर इवेंट में इवेंट है उसमें कोई चीज उससे मिस ना हो जाए, क्योंकि शादी में मान लो 30, 50, 100 अलग अलग चीजें होती हैं, उसमें कोई एक चीज मिस हो गई तो काफी एम्बेरसमेंट होगी एट द पर्टिकुलर टाइम जब उसकी जरूरत पड़ेगी. तो एक बेसिक वो चीज है, इसलिए वो सर्च करेगा इसको. इसमें कस्टमर दो तरीके से हो गए, एक तो एंड कस्टमर जिसको वेडिंग के लिए जो सर्च करेगा सर्विस की, और दूसरा जो हमारे लिए कस्टमर है वो वेंडर जो हमें रेवेन्यू देगा. ये सर्विस सर्विस डोमेन के अंदर है. दूसरा टारगेट ग्रुप जो हमारा कस्टमर है, उसमें जो हमारा कस्टमर है नियरली 45 लाख जो स्टूडेंट्स निकलते हैं ग्रेजुएट्स, तो करीबन हमने जो लगाया है कि 15 लाख शादियां इंडिया के अंदर होती हैं, उसका हम 5% मार्केट को टारगेट करेंगे फर्स्ट ईयर के अंदर. ये जो होगा हमारा, इसमें जो टारगेट हमारा ग्रुप है, जो सेगमेंट है, उसके अंदर ये जरूरी है कि उसको कंप्यूटर से वो वाकिफ हो, उसे कंप्यूटर यूज करना आता हो, और इंटरनेट एक्सेसिबिलिटी उसके पास हो. ठीक है, ये जो सेगमेंट हमने चूज किया है. तीसरा चीज जो है वो हमारा प्राइस है. प्राइस जो एंड कस्टमर है जिसने मैरिज के लिए सर्विस को सर्च करना है, उसको उसके लिए कोई प्राइस नहीं है, वो सर्च भी फ्री में करेगा और अपने आप को रजिस्टर भी फ्री में करेगा. सेकंड, जो वेंडर लिस्ट करेगा, वेंडर अपने आप को फ्री में लिस्ट करेगा, क्योंकि वेंडर को हम रिस्ट्रिक्ट नहीं करना चाहते कि वो लिस्टिंग करे. तो इस हिसाब से जितने भी 10 मेट्रोपॉलिटन सिटीज या जो बड़ी सिटीज हैं, उनके सब वेंडर्स हमारे लिए फ्री में अपने आप को लिस्ट कर सकते हैं. फ्री लिस्टिंग के अंदर वो अपना नाम, अपना एड्रेस और फोन नंबर लिस्ट कर सकता है. उससे नेक्स्ट लेवल पे अगर उसको जाना है, अपनी लिस्टिंग करनी है, लिस्टिंग में अगर वो चाहता है कि उसकी फोटोग्राफ्स और उसका वीडियोस और उसकी जो वेबसाइट है वेंडर की, उसको लिंक अगर वो करना चाहता है, तो उसको कुछ पैसे देने पड़ेंगे. वो पैसे हमने वर्कआउट करके करीबन 5,000 रुपया साल का रखा है. ठीक है, उसके अलावा ये लिस्टिंग के ऊपर आ गया, लिस्टिंग में उसकी जो स्पेस होगी, जो टेक्स्ट जो सर्च रिजल्ट में आएगा वो बढ़ जाएगा थोड़ा. और उसके अलावा लिस्टिंग अगर वो करना चाहता हो तो राइट साइड, जैसे मैंने चंडीगढ़ के अंदर सर्च किया मान लो फोटोग्राफर, और इसमें मैं ये बताना चाहूंगा कि जो एंड यूजर होगा उसको वेंडर सर्च खुद मैं देख लूंगा कि वेंडर कहां से सर्च कर रहा है, चंडीगढ़ से सर्च कर रहा है, तो ऑलरेडी वो जो फोटोग्राफ चूज करेगा तो चंडीगढ़ के राइट साइड में गूगल मैप आएगा, वो उसको दिखाएगा कि उसके जो जहां से वो सर्च कर रहा है उसके पास सबसे पास कौन से वेंडर थे जो फोटोग्राफर थे, और साथ में उनकी रेटिंग दिखेगी कि ये रेटिंग इस वेंडर की क्या है, अभी तक किस किस ने इसको यूज किया है. रेटिंग के साथ उसको नीचे ये भी दिखेगा कि टेस्टिमोनियल्स जो इसके यूजर रहे हैं उसका अब तक का टेस्टिमोनियल कैसा है, उससे रिलायबिलिटी उस वेंडर की थोड़ी एस्टेब्लिश होगी, क्योंकि वो उसकी बेसिक नीड है कि उसको रिलायबल वेंडर चाहिए. प्राइस के अंदर जो ब्रेक जो केपेक्स है वो 1 लाख रुपया करीबन डेवलपमेंट के अंदर लगेगा और 3 लाख रुपया करीबन मार्केटिंग के अंदर इसका खर्च होगा। और इस हिसाब से जो हम लेते हैं, अगर हम 80 से 100 कस्टमर भी जो 5000 रुपए हमें देने के लिए तैयार होते हैं तो ओके, ये करीबन 6 महीने में ब्रेक इवन करेंगे। मार्केटिंग हम करेंगे गूगल एडवर्ड्स के थ्रू और अपनी वेबसाइट की सर्च इंजन ऑप्टिमाइजेशन करेंगे हम, और टाई अप करेंगे वेडिंग साइट्स जैसे shaadi.com, matrimonial.com, और मार्केटिंग के थ्रू भी करेंगे, ब्लॉग्स के थ्रू करेंगे, इस तरीके से हम करेंगे। और समर इंटर्न्स को भी हम यूज करेंगे मार्केटिंग और मार्केटिंग के लिए, तो ऐसा है। थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर
टीम टू इज रेडी।
द प्रोडक्ट वी आर come across as Mopcast. Okay, so this is for this product we are targeting is live streaming of videos through mobile phones. Okay, so our team is Ashok, myself, Kishore and Anurag. Okay, so I'll be taking care of the technology part. Finance will be handled by Anurag. Marketing will be done by Ashok, and sales and operation would be taken care by Kishore. Okay, so I'll just introduce and brief. The concept is like we want to provide streaming videos through mobile phones. Okay, so we are expecting the bandwidth of internet to go as we, as you know, the technology grows. So there will be a need for live streaming of videos through mobile phone and cameras. So there would be a software on the mobile phone through which you know, you can send or receive live streaming videos. Okay, so that streaming video will go to the server. It will be also recorded on the server. That will that video will be stored on the server and also broadcasted to people whom the user wants to share the video with. Okay, so it is like a fun concept. Suppose there is a marriage, okay, and you know, some of my friends are not there in the marriage, okay. So through mobile phones, you know, they can view the marriage, okay. Or there is some rock concert, I want to share that rock concert with my friend. So it is like that, okay. So the target users are, you know, general users who want to share streaming videos on mobile phones for fun. And business users who want heterogeneous video conferencing, that means a few people are on the web and few people are on the mobile phones. So the services that we plan to offer through this portal are sharing of videos with your friends through mobile phone, storing of that video on the website, web server, advertisers, so there will be advertisements both on the website and on the streaming video. Okay, paid up services for business users who want to do video conferencing. Then tag based key search facility for users who want to search videos on the website. Live training, you know, if some users want to give live training through their mobile phones, so that will be a paid service. Then telemedicine for those places where you know, you don't have any facility of internet, okay, and encrypted videos for secure business conferences. So suppose some business requires secure secure video conferencing, so for them there is encrypted service. Okay, so how do we plan to go about marketing? Okay, so first we can generate revenue through this. We can get started only after we have 1000 users. Okay, so for that what we plan to do is there are power bloggers you know, whose blog attract at least around 10,000 internet users. Okay, so our plan is to get in touch with such bloggers, ask them to use the service and write a blog on it. Also there are a lot of freelance writers who want new topics to put it on, let's say Sunday's newspaper or Ladies Gadgets or something like that, supplements that comes in the newspaper. Okay, so this way means if you are reaching to 1 lakh people through these power bloggers and freelance, okay, we expect to get around 1000 users, registered users in the first 3 months. Okay, once that is done, then we can approach the advertisers. Okay, so what we estimate is that It takes around 30 paise to 50 paise for an advertiser to put a pamphlet of his product in newspaper. Okay, so we have 1,000 users. So let's say 1,000 into 50, that's 500 rupees. We can charge the advertisers and put his advertisement on the website. So that advertisement, how do we add value to these advertisements? So that will be tag based. Okay, so suppose user has put a tag on his video, like my tennis match. Okay, so we'll be placing ads of racket manufacturers or sports, you know, sports shops on that. Okay, so this is how we want to provide value to the advertisers. Okay, now since our application requires sharing, you know, means even users, you can have fun with this application only if there are more than two users involved in this. So we expect these first 1,000 users to spread a word about this service and generate around 10,000 users in next 3 months. Okay, so once we have around 10,000 users on the site within our first 6 months of launching, so we will start putting ads on live streaming of the videos. Okay, so we plan to put a price of 50 paise per user per minute. Okay, so if you want to put an ad, if an advertiser wants to put an ad, he has to pay 50 paise per user per minute. Okay, so that is one service. So this is how over a period of 6 to 8 months we plan to build a brand. Okay, so once everybody knows about the brand, okay, then we can approach the business users about this service. Okay, and then start paid service for business users. Okay, so
your time is up.
Okay,
myself, I'm Ishwar. My name is Nageshwar. I'm Ishwar. I'm the team leader, and I have Mazumdar, Ms. Khan, and Mr. Patil with me. They are my teammates, and we have come out this idea. Let me just share the idea with you. We are planning to release CFL bulbs. I mean, this is a common thing, CFL bulbs. Like in one of our professor was sharing, we have around 45 companies in India competing with each other today about CFL bulbs. But the business plan here is a different one. I don't need to share the importance or, you know, significance of using CFL bulb over a normal bulb today, because it's quite obvious and all of us know about it. Now, coming to the business model, what we plan to do is we want to do an outsourcing model. We would want to get in touch with a Taiwan-based outsourcer who will be an OEM equipment provider for us. We'll take the equipment from him in bulk, and he'll provide us at a comparatively good cost. And then he would be providing us this in extra 1 year warranty than the other providers today in the market. Now with that, we would want to, our distribution mechanism is different. We would want to approach the power distribution companies, say for example AP Transco in AP, and then Reliance, Tata, all these companies in the other states. So what we want to do is we approach them and then say that we have our approximate, I would not go in sequential as and when we come across, I'll now discuss about pricing. Our pricing is approximately 145 rupees, taking a 90 rupees FOB from Taiwan. After 90 rupees, we add 30% taxes, we add our distribution cost and all this, it would come to 145 rupees. So we would add a margin of 40 rupees, so our price is 185 rupees. This is what we charge to a distribution company like AP Transco. The way we collect the money is we give the incandescent CFL bulb to AP Transco, who would then take this bulb and then go for changing the bulb, normal bulb with a incandescent or CFL bulb. Now this money will be collected back in 5 installments. Now the advantage for end user here is he would, for by changing that, every user would be saving approximately 8 to 10 rupees in his current bill every month. Now for out of 245 rupees, 185 rupees, if you take 5 installments, he would be paying say 40 to 50 rupees, and then you'll be paying 40 rupees, out of which 8 rupees is again saved from his current bulb. Now by doing this, AP Transco, the distribution company in this context, will get approximately distribution cost of 5 to 10 rupees for every bulb change. Now because all government of India and other state governments are showing keen interest in changing their, saving the energy, and then also 55% of Indian rural, rural sector is not electrified yet. So there's a lot of market that can be captured here. So if we can get in touch with AP transmission companies or any other power distribution companies, we give them, they will go implement this.
they'll get their benefit of saving the power. Government has its own keen interest in, you know, ensuring that there is no energy deficiency, energy this one requirement in the India, in the country today. So by this, what we will get is we will get 5 equal installments. We get around 15 to 20% of profits. The approximate cost that would be required is approximately for 5 lakh units, you take a 200 rupees, including all things, it would come down to 10 crores. With a government order, I am sure that banks would be ready to fund 60 to 70% on a government order. And then we would, as promoters, 4 of us would fund it from our pockets, the remaining 3 crores. And yeah, that's the fundamental idea I have. I think in coming to promotion, see, what we plan to do is the way when we brand it Ather, we want to co-brand with the power distribution company in that particular area. It will be AP Transco and Ather going together. Ather is a premium brand which is available in other retail outlets at a very costly premium of 280 to 300 rupees. The idea of releasing it to retail outlets is not because it's our target market, but to create the awareness from the this one. Tomorrow we don't want to go to a household and then say that you exchange your bulb, and then they should not say Wipro bulb is available at 210 rupees, why should I take yours? So we want to create that awareness in the brand, saying that it is in the people. We want to position ourselves as a premium brand who is aware of green emissions, you know, works with this one on a NGO, a social cause for it, so this one.
So you have 30 seconds.
Okay. So I'll tell you the other 2 means of promotion. We want to advertise with state governments bearing 50% cost on us. We want to work with all the distribution employees who would bear a t-shirt saying that we are doing this for 2 reasons. One is environment and public interest. We would go for news coverage when we release this. And thanks for giving this opportunity.
Hello, good evening to all. We are group 4. We consist of myself, Shantanu, Arvind, Dr. Chandratre, and Professor Chandratre, and Dr. Jose. Looking at all the technological ideas, we came up with a very simple stuff. And why does everybody want to earn money? It's finally everybody would say in Hindi, it's like, papi pet ka sawal hai bhaiya. So it's like, why don't we start with that? We came up with a very simple concept of starting fast food, ready to eat eatery outlet. I'm not sure that most of you are knowing that, but when you come to south of India, you find that quite a few of these eateries are available where you get fast food very easily available, especially when you talk about idlis and dosas. We have a lot of them in Bangalore and that side. We thought we could use this concept, but limiting ourselves to one particular offering of dosa. But offering of dosa, now we have a lot of varieties in that. There's some unique points that we added to this concept was, first thing, we have one price for around 20 varieties of dosa that we are offering. Constant price. Secondly, we assure you a fast service of less than 3 minutes. And we are offering a price which is probably the below everybody which is offering in these parts of India. It's 15 rupees. Why we are offering that is for a reason. Now, why we are offering that is we want to target a person who is typically going, you know, he's in a hurry, he's just going by and he just grabs a vada pav and just catches a train, something like that. Vada pav typically costs something like 7 to 8 rupees, and we are keeping this just at the cost of something like 2 vada pavs. But one dosa is enough to satisfy your something like a breakfast need or a need of your stomach for a pretty good amount of time. So that is why we price at that place. And as I said, who is my customer? A person who is on a go and wants a hygienically prepared food, yeah, and definitely a tasty food. These are some of the points of who is my customer. Now, what are the advantages that he gets? First thing, he is not worried about the price because it's constant about whatever dosa he wants to eat. Second thing, he has a variety. He need not eat the same taste for, let us say, if he eats one variety today and 15 days hence, he has 15 different varieties as well. Third one is as a variety, there is a different taste to it. So you are not bogged down by the same taste every day. Fourth is the availability and convenience. Now this is the one of the areas that we are targeting. Availability. Now we are putting up these shops or ready-to-eat shops right across railway stations, so that where, you know, usually when we are in a hurry and traveling, we usually try and you skip your breakfast or skip something, and then you are at the point when you're boarding it, and you remember, okay, I need to have something for my stomach. This is the place exactly before you enter, or probably after you get down, you have something to eat right in front. Yeah. The fourth point is we are operating 24 hours. So that means at any given point of time, we are not letting you go hungry. In this mode, and there is no like, this is not a restaurant kind of stuff. So we just stand, eat, or take away whatever we have ordered for. So these are the two modes, either stand and eat or take it away. And the time of delivery is plain 3 minutes. For this, we just made a rough calculations of whatever data we had. Let us say an approximate 10 by 10 shop area would rent approximately about 50,000 rupees nearby to peak areas like railway stations and bus stand and like that. The cost of labor would be something like, okay, I'll just wrap up the whole thing. I would say a monthly recurring cost of 86,000 rupees is expected, and the total fixed cost that we are taking into account is something like 4 lakhs, which is 2 lakhs for the deposit and 2 lakhs for the infrastructure that we are taking into account. And what we approximately calculated was the cost of making one dosa is 5 rupees. So we are making a margin of 10 dosas per minute. With that, we are, the worst comes scenario of, you know, what is the volume of dosas that we can make. So we calculate that approximately 500 dosas per day should be good. Thank you.
Okay, good evening everybody. My name is Saurabh Jain. We are from team number 5 and we are called the Socialpreneurs. Okay, the product I'm going to talk to you about is called Eventazoo, which is an online event registration ticket planning service. Okay, so I'll start with an example. All of us registered for this event, the Marketing Mantra event. So how did we go about it? First, like, we got an email, then we went to a website, we filled it up, then we submitted it. Then after that, we took out a printout of it, attached a DD to it, couriered it. It came all the way here. Then the courier was confirmed, and then our participation was confirmed. Now, if you look at it, there are so many different aspects to this entire process. You know, you have to wonder whether the courier reached on time, etc., etc. So what Eventazoo does in this case is that anybody like who can use computers, they can go online, create an event, specify the forms they want, the questions they want to ask, and your website goes online. We also provide ticketing services, so the money which you have collected via DD, you could have collected it online via credit cards or net banking. So in this case, what happens is you go online, fill in your details, enter a credit card number, and you can print out a ticket and come directly here. No need of couriering a DD, etc., etc. So who's the target customers? Basically, we are targeting our primary customers are, you know, college students, NGOs, specialty clubs like, you know, CSI, etc., who have these events. Our primary USP is that our software, or it's a web application, is very, very easy to use. So anybody, you know, who has a basic knowledge of computers can go online, create an event within 5 minutes. We give you a complete website, we give you a web hosting, a domain name, and we also give you a form along with tickets. You can sell tickets online. So any person can go up, create an entire form and take registration online. So our target, how do we plan to market our services, that we have a primary account which is free to use so that you can try out our service before having to pay for it. Then we have done a market research in which we know which colleges, which groups have their events when. So before the event actually occurs, we send them an email or, like, you know, contact them telling them, why don't you try us out this time, and things like that. The other thing is, how do we approach our target audience? And a lot of these event organizers, the large event organizers, nowadays everything, all the events which are occurring, they have the registrations online. You know, the cost of setting up a booth offline and taking registrations and the money, etc., it's a huge amount. So one approach is, you know, tying up with these event organizers and giving them bulk discounts so that for the events they can go online and, you know, ask people to register online for an event. Well, for the pricing of the event, we have a couple of competitors in India And what we believe is they have an unfair pricing model. So what they do is they charge you a one-time setup fee, say, of 14 to 15,000 rupees. And then per event, they charge you about 5,000, 7,000 rupees. On top of this, they charge you per ticket sale made. So our pricing model is completely different. We don't want to, you know, like latch on to you. So all you do is you pay per event. So if you have an event which is less than 250 people, you pay us about 5,000 rupees one time. And then we charge you a small 5% of your ticket sales. And for larger events, more than 250 people, we charge you about 10,000 rupees. And then at that time, the ticket sale, we charge you 3.5% instead of 5%. So that's where we you get an advantage. The other thing is from where are we getting funds for it. So basically, we have our own consultancy services, which the excess revenue surplus is being put into the development of this product. And besides this, we are expecting to break even in the next 3 months. And besides this, we also have a contingency fund of families and friends, etc. Finally, the team competency. We have about 4 developers working on this. All these developers were previously, they organized events in their own colleges. And hence, you know, they understand the pain points of developing a product like this. We have a person on a board of mentors. Board of mentors who's been in the software development for the past 10 years, and he's been helping us with the delivery processes, etc. And besides this, we have about 3 event organizers, big event management companies, their managers on a board of advisors who are constantly helping us with, you know, what's in, what's out, and things like that. Thank you, ma'am.
Hi, I'm Rohini. The name of my team is Team Talk, and I'm the team leader. My members are Arvind G. Prasad, Maheshwar Appa K.N., and Sanjeev Natkani. Now, a little bit about our product. The Team Talk presents ready-to-broadcast programs called Disha that guides businessmen and startup business on how to run business and solve problems. These programs are by experienced industrialists and are available to all the people anytime, anywhere, as well as on the news channels. The product, as you understand, is a recorded program that provides guidance to existing and startup entrepreneurs online and offline. It's a B2B program. We plan to sell it to the channels like CNBC, NDTV Profit. Also, make this program available on the web, whereby the would-be entrepreneurs and the existing entrepreneurs can access it on the web anytime, anywhere. Why will the channels buy this? The channels will buy this because they are getting content which is ready-made. And for this, running this program, they can also get sponsorship from the financial institutions that give support to the business as well as VCs. This is very important because, as you know, the state in the current state of economy, it is very difficult to find sponsors. Currently, what is available are competitors. They are mainly the agencies that are conducting EDPs and MDPs. Agencies like NEN, EDISL, IIMs. There is also a program currently available on Doordarshan and All India Radio by an organization called DEIS. But it is in Marathi and only meant for the Marathi-speaking people, whereas our program will be broadcasted in English and for the urban youth. Why did we come across this product idea? We came because if you try to search on the web, any material that is related to starting a business, it is mostly the content is related to the business opportunities which are abroad. You will hardly find any material with any context to the Indian markets. For marketing this, we are going to appoint a team of five salespersons who will be directly approaching the channel members, the media, and they will make a small clip will be shown, and then the program will be sold. The capital outlay is 2 lakh rupees. Annual revenue expected is 21,02,000. Total profit is 6,25,724. Total expenses are 13,92,200 rupees. The profit margin is 30%. We expect a sale of 239 units over the year. In the first few months, first quarter, we will be making a sale of 5 units, which will then gradually increase. In the first quarter, we will be selling 4 units, second quarter 73, and 155 units in the third quarter. And our sales per unit cost is 19,795 rupees, which is very cheap if you look at any production house, or these channel people. If you go and sell this one CD with a recorded program, the profit margins for them also will be pretty high. Well, that's all.
Good evening, gentlemen. I'm Guru Prasad. I, along with my colleagues Srikant, Sharat, and Raghu, so we are presenting one new concept. Before naming the concept, just I wanted to tell you how this concept came into our mind, are converted into a business. Actually, we were traveling on various occasions for our business for various places. So when we want to travel to the new places, we used to just check Google Maps, sometimes Google Terrain, where is this location, how I have to travel, how I need to reach there and all. So this is the normal process most of us are doing. So when we are doing that, one day when we are in a meeting, one great idea struck. Hare yaar, why can't we build a model of the building? Now, as of now, we are seeing only the flat location of the top image of the location, wherever. Suppose today also when I was about to come here, just I saw where it is, how far it is located from the airport. I was able to see only the campus, but I could not see the building. Can we do the model? That's how this idea came into our thought. The minute when this thought came, we started working on it. Is it really a viable? Is it a viable concept with which we can really spend some money and make it into a marketing concept? Then myself and my colleagues went on, did some market research with various segments, and we went with all the people who are already having the buildings. They really wanted this model, but they were not ready to pay. They said, I do need the model, but why should I pay? Then we went to the builders and developers who really wanted this kind of models, who are ready to pay. And that research, whatever analysis we have made, they showed that yes, if I could show my building which is already, it is not yet built, for a person who is sitting away from Dubai or in New York, why not? The question was why not? Then we started working on, can we build a model? So then we started working on this concept. This concept, we have named it as geo-reference model. So that means a model which has an actual geographical location. So this model will have an actual shape, size, and placed on the actual location of Google Earth. So this concept we are presenting today as one of the new concept as geo-reference model. So I'll repeat, geo-reference model is the model of an existing building or an upcoming building on the actual location of Google Earth. Once it is done, anybody across the globe can access this model. Okay, this is the concept. So then when the concept is done, so we did research, and then we have developed the product, and we also tested with few market developers and builders. They have given the green signal for this. So after this, when we have built any model or any new technology, the reaching the target audience is the next very, very important thing. So if the technology is affordable, everybody will access it, and it will reach most of the people. So that's why we, next third step, what we thought is how to give this technology to the masses. So even though we know about 3D modeling, 3D modeling is in India since 10 years, but there is no market penetration. We found out what is the reason. The reason was the 3D modeling, the whole concept was very expensive, where I and you cannot afford it. Maybe a person who is building, having a project of 100 crores, 10 crores may access it. Then we thought, can we reduce the cost of the model? Yes, there was a way. So Google has allowed Google Earth free. Then the modeling tools also, if you could make free, and the models are available at an affordable cost, we felt that yes, it can be. So with a lot of research, we have brought out this concept at a very affordable cost, and now we want to market this across the country through all the builders and developers. The concept is this. The technology I have explained. then how to reach the masses. So our target segment is now the real estate. So even in the real estate, we are looking for commercial real estate. 30 seconds. Through the commercial real estate, and we want to market this through the portals. So we do have a lot of portals across the country. We already approached the portals to market this, and they have readily accepted and given the consent to market this. Through 4 regional offices, we want to market this concept of geo-reference modeling. In 3 years, we want to be the market leaders, and we want to take maximum market share in the area of geo-reference model. To conclude, so we have come up with a very fine concept. We don't want to sell just a model. So we want to see how the real estate marketing area, the real estate marketing in India will change in next 3 years. This is our motive. Thank you.
Hi, good evening. My name is Rohit Nalvede. I'm representing a team called Track Next. We are launching a new service to the market. The service is called Child Tracker. Now, Child Tracker essentially does, you know, what the name essentially suggests. It tracks school-going kids. It does 5 things. In the morning, it tells the parents that the school bus is due in another 5 minutes, or the school bus is punctured 2 bus stops away, and it's going to take 30 minutes to come to this bus stop. So instead of 8:30, please go to the bus stop at 9 a.m. The bus comes to the bus stop. The kid gets into the school bus. Immediately, his attendance is marked at the school. Now, the kid is on his way to the school, and if parents haven't received the next alert, which is saying, hey, the kid has reached school, he's on time, or he's late, or he's early to school, parents can at any point in time send an SMS saying location question mark, and immediately get a location saying your kid Rohit is still in the bus, and the bus is delayed because of traffic, and he'll take 10 more minutes to reach school. Now, the kid reaches the school. The moment he enters the school premises and is inside his classroom, he's safe and secure. Parents get another SMS alert saying, your kid Rohit has reached school, he's late, or he's on time, or he's early. During the day, if there are any academic updates, for example, particularly for very small kids, if they have an English test, or they have, or the school is closing early, the class teacher can send just one SMS saying class 6A space English test on Monday, and send it to a SMS number, and the system will replicate this SMS and send it to all kids, all parents of class 3A students. So parents get an acknowledgement, and they could reply to it saying yes or no. Now, after the school gets over, the kid again comes out of the school and boards the school bus. Parents again get an SMS saying your kid is leaving from school, he's traveling by bus number 12, which is his usual route, and the expected time of arrival at your bus stop is 2:45 p.m. Please be there to pick up the kid. Or your kid is traveling by bus number 10 today, which is not his usual route. This bus goes to all these places, along with the timings at the respective bus stops. And around 10 minutes before the bus is expected at their destination bus stop, parents again get an alert saying the bus is about to come in 10 minutes, or it is again late by 30 minutes. Please go to the bus stop accordingly. The target group for this to start with is essentially premium schools. By premium, we mean there are 2 different categorizations. One is by the target income group of the parents, and the cities in which they stay in. So the target segment is essentially parents who, where both the husband and the wife are working, in cities like Bombay, Chennai, Delhi and NCR, and Bangalore, where most young couples are working professionals with a monthly household income of a lakh rupees or more, sending their kids to schools where the monthly fees is 2,000 rupees or more. We'd launch with a small set of schools in each one of these cities, for example, 2 schools in Bombay, 2 schools in Delhi and NCR, and so on. These schools would become a reference basis, which will create a very positive word of mouth. And based on that positive word of mouth, we'll get into partnerships with local companies who are already selling some kind of software to school. For example, there are a lot of companies which are selling SMS alert systems to school. There are companies which are selling school management system. So this system can eventually piggyback or, you know, connect with those systems, and we can leverage their existing partnerships or existing relationships with the schools and go to schools. In terms of the pricing, we price the product at 120 rupees a month. The monthly running cost for us is around 20 rupees, including all the SMS messages and managing the server data traffic. 120 rupees, because 20 rupees would go to school, and 100 rupees is, we believe, the right price point. It's neither too high. It's 5% of 2,000 rupees a month fee, so it's not a really large number. It's 1440 rupees a year, which if the total fee is 25,000 rupees, isn't a number that would make parents or parent teacher association or the principal really think. 20 rupees goes to the school, so school is essentially earning some money out of this for providing their help and collecting the fee and remitting it to us. And even for schools which can afford slightly more than that, 100 rupees still remains a notional price point. It's just 100 rupees. In terms of the marketing plan, like I said, we'll launch with few cities. In each city, we'll get pilots, we'll get positive word of mouth and eventually grow it. In terms of team, we have been actually very fortunate, you know, by coincidence, four people have come together. We have Bhushan. Bhushan has been an entrepreneur for around 15 years, has sold to institutions, has strong sales and marketing expertise. So he'll be doing the business development, all of these, identifying these school partners. And then we have Professor Trickle, who's an academician with around 13 years experience. He would help us essentially go and, you know, pitch it to the first few schools, and an academician selling to academicians. Thanks.
A very good afternoon to each one of you all. My name is Sheba. I represent a team named Tech 5, and I would like to introduce the members. I would like to introduce Mr. Prakash, Jaskaran, Aditya, and Goran. Our product's name is iOpportune.com. Before I go to what the product is about, the need we have identified will reminiscent you about your college days when you were frenetically looking for internship. So it is a need of every student, a final year student. Internship is a need of every final year student. And the problem that is faced by them is that they cannot find the internship in the area of their interest. Every student thinks that internship is as important as him finding a very good job at the end of his education. So iOpportune is a portal that connects students to corporates. Our theme is college to corporate. So I would like to introduce Jaskaran, who would be talking about the marketing plan further.
Thanks, Shiva. Actually, our concept is basically in India, there are many students who pass out from professional degree colleges, but they are unable to find any job. So in between, there is a concept which is coming up in India, is concept of finishing schools. That finishing school concept is still not working because student is not willing to pay after paying such a hefty fees in a professional degree college. So what we the concept that we have come up with along with my team is iOpportune. I for internet and I for its regarding a personal. Opportune is for opportunity for students. So these students, this is a general scenario. After our research, we found out, since I am an electronics engineer, when I was in my fourth year, it was very hard for me to find out a company where I can do internship, unless and until I don't have any social contacts. So to overcome this problem, and this is not in only in engineering college, it's almost in all professional colleges due to the education system in India. So focusing on Indian scenario, we'll be launching this website, and the basic will be that a student who is willing to do in every student in their last year in professional goals, they have to go internships. So for doing that internship, student will register in our website. So it is basically, we are catering to students and the corporates, students that too doing professional courses. So when a student registers with his or her resume in our website, there will be recruiters, there will be companies which will be there in our website, they will be registered in our website. So our basic revenue model in this is that the company which is going to get registered will be paying rupees 5,000 for a year to get access to the database of students who will be doing internship. The benefits companies will be getting is that in a very nominal cost of rupees 5,000, they'll be getting an access to a great, you know, database bank in which all of the students will be professionals, and giving training to a student for internship will definitely help out a company, because internship can be converted into jobs. So that reduces the cost on the company's side. And for the student, it is very much beneficial, because a student is not going to pay any much more and not going to waste a time after doing 4 years or 5 years of degree time. So that's the basic thing. And the first and foremost thing is that student will get a focused path of their career. So this is the revenue model. Our basic capex would be 4 lakh rupees, including rented office space and computers. My counterpart, Gaurang, is a developer, and I'm looking after the marketing team. And my three partners are looking for the development of managing the operations. So we are looking forward for 15,000 registrations in 1 year, and 150 to 200 companies will be registered in a year. So our break-even point would be 1 year. That is comes up to 10 lakhs. Thank you.